Space exploration and the space industry is one of the most booming industries today. Space exploration helps to address fundamental questions about our place in the universe and the history of our solar system. Through addressing the challenges related to human space exploration, we expand technology, create new industries, and help to foster a peaceful connection with other nations. Today, a lot of government and private organizations are working on developing space technologies and exploring outer space. During the Cold War, a space race started between the Americans and the Soviets, which led to a rapid development of the space industry and a lot of space missions thereafter. But since the Cold War ended, it seems that NASA limited its missions and also called off all moon missions. It's shocking to know that we haven't sent someone to the moon since 1972, when we were far less capable in terms of technology. To boldly go where no man has gone before excites us and also instills some fear. Since the development of space travel, only three countries have launched a man into space. The first was Russian cosmonaut Yuri Gagarin, who orbited the Earth in Vostok 1. The second was the USA launching Alan Shepard into space. It wasn't until 2003 China launched its first man into space. But with the exciting new and cheap technologies that the private space sector companies are providing, developments over the next few years will make space greater again. Today in this video, we are going to discuss about and compare two space organizations, NASA and SpaceX. Before discussing something more, we want to make it sure that this video is not intended to hate on NASA. NASA is one of the first most revolutionary space organizations that reformed space. We just want to highlight the operational differences between SpaceX and NASA. NASA has achieved truly incredible things, but will the organization have to move over for Elon Musk's amazing spacecraft technologies? But before talking more about this comparison, let us answer an even important question that many people raise during such conversations. Is comparing NASA and SpaceX fair? Well, it's not quite that simple. One is a government agency that has been there for decades, and the other is a young private company hungry for more. Sometimes it may seem that it's unfair to compare these two, but in general we can compare their cost efficiency and their rockets. NASA, or the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, was created in 1958 when President Dwight D. Eisenhower signed the National Aeronautics and Space Act. According to the act, NASA's space exploration would forever be devoted to peaceful purposes for the benefit of all mankind. But despite of the peaceful conception, it was formed primarily as a response to the Soviet Union, who had already put something into the orbit before the USA. And in a few decades, NASA went on from a little aerospace entity to a full-fledged advanced organization capable of putting humans on the surface of the moon. NASA had a strong competitor, the Soviets, which not only fueled their growth, but also the mindset of people. But since the Cold War ended, things changed. NASA didn't have the same enthusiasm as before, which is evident of the fact that since 1972, there hasn't been a man to the moon. But in the last few years, a new golden era began in the space industry because of the revived interest of people in space. And one of the main reasons behind that is SpaceX. SpaceX, created by multi-talented tech entrepreneur Elon Musk, was founded on May 6, 2002. Musk is eventually planning on colonizing Mars, which he had made it clear several times. Musk has also said that by 2024, SpaceX will have completed a manned mission to Mars. And in the summer of 2020, SpaceX became the first private company to send astronauts into space. The United States has not launched its own astronauts into space since the space shuttle program ended in 2011. Since then, NASA has had to pay Russia for its Soyuz rockets to take American astronauts to space. It paid more than $3 billion for SpaceX to design, build, test, and operate its reusable capsule for six future space round trips. So why has NASA not used its own spacecrafts? Well, let's start the comparison between SpaceX and NASA and see what is wrong with NASA's plan. The question we must first ask is who has the most funding and the more advanced technology? Elon Musk himself is the third richest man as of October 2020 and is worth over $100 billion. SpaceX has raised over $1.9 billion in new funding in August, representing its largest single fundraising round to date. SpaceX makes most of its money from delivering payloads for NASA and launching commercial satellites into space. NASA, on the other hand, has suffered from underfunding over the years, which is one of the reasons why progress regarding the exploration of space has been ponderous since the moon landing. In 2016, President Barack Obama increased the budget of around $500 million, bringing the total budget to $19 billion. In 2020, the Trump administration called for an increase of $3 billion in NASA's budget for the lunar landing in 2024, but it was denied by the House Appropriations Committee. If we look at the amount of money the USA spends on its military, which is around $700 billion, even if it spends a couple of billion dollars more, it will boost NASA's functioning. So we can see here that there may be a space race between SpaceX and NASA for going to Mars. NASA has had a lot of setbacks besides the underfunding. It lost two of its space shuttles in 1986 and 2003. 15 astronauts have been killed in total, which did not help NASA's ambitions. NASA's space shuttle program was revolutionary, as it was the first major step at regularizing space travel and introducing the concept of rocket reusability. However, one realm in which it was now revolutionary was cost. Despite one of the main promises of the space shuttle being cheaper spaceflight, like with most other government-sponsored programs, this space shuttle program fell flat on its face, clocking in at a total of $209 billion, or $1.6 billion per launch. To put this in perspective, the SpaceX Crew Dragon cost $209 million per launch, meaning that with the $209 billion, NASA could have launched 1,000 Crew Dragons as opposed to the 134 space shuttle flights. SpaceX is also aiming to push down the cost of Starship to $2 billion. So what's wrong with NASA? One of the biggest mistakes that NASA made was being too ambitious on the space shuttle program. Many experts think that NASA should have improved upon the Apollo design and tried to cut down the costs instead of building a brand new vehicle from scratch. NASA tried to pack this new space shuttle with as much technology they could, and as a result, they made it more complex. This led to some pretty hefty development costs, and the repair and maintenance costs were a nightmare. There could have been many simpler designs that were suggested, which would have reduced a lot of other issues. Also, the space shuttle program was run far too long. Instead of running for 15 years as planned, it ran for 30 years. But it's not all NASA's fault, because at the same time, the construction of the ISS was approved, and it was being developed. The space shuttle was the only vehicle that could carry ISS parts into orbit, and NASA wasn't going to design a new vehicle for that. The project was already delayed for many years, and so NASA had no choice other than to reuse the space shuttle at a very expensive price. NASA plans to step away from supporting the space station by 2024. In order to divert the funding to other projects. So at the end of the day, it's a bit questionable if it was worth running the space shuttle program for another two decades from the economical point of view. However, ISS is undoubtedly one of the greatest achievements humanity has ever achieved. And the final drawback of the space shuttle was that it didn't have a crystal clear goal. It was meant to create viable space travel, but it was made for more than that. Otherwise, why design such a complex vehicle rather than having an economically friendly design? Also, at that time, the public excitement started to decrease. The USA had already been to the moon and had beaten the USSR in the space race, so now they didn't have any competition, and that is also a very important reason for the success of SpaceX, which has very good competition from a lot of organizations nowadays. People nowadays want to go to Mars, and this interest was first mentioned and brought upon in people by Elon Musk. Things like colonies on Mars, space travel, space stations, and having a vacation in space has renewed people's interest in space, which also has started the new space race. the space shuttle didn't get such an excitement from people, and so didn't have a clearly defined purpose. SpaceX, on the other hand, didn't make this mistake. It didn't just focus on the technology and performance, but also reduced the cost and made space travel cheaper without compromising the safety, whereas most government organizations spend decades on just performance, which has resulted in the government funding of these space organizations less. SpaceX runs like a startup, which is focused on both quality and cost. In NASA, a normal employee would work a maximum of 40 to 50 hours, but in SpaceX, employees work for 80 hours, which sometimes extend into 100 hours a week. And this is not because of any pressure. These people could have any job in any company on this planet, but their decision and vision of SpaceX drives them, which sets SpaceX far ahead in the game. This is why the productivity of employers is doubled, and their designs and technology are efficient and also cheaper. Since SpaceX is a private company, it faces tough competition from other companies and has to even compete with companies like Blue Origin and NASA themselves to win contracts from NASA. SpaceX also has a free flying spacecraft called Dragon, which was the first commercial spacecraft ever launched by a private company. Initially, it carried only cargo to the ISS, but in the summer of 2020, it became the first private company to carry astronauts to space. NASA currently has a lot of missions already running that are very amazing, and it is an undeniable fact that the space industry is what it is today, all because of NASA. There is a high level of competition between both the companies, but at the end of the day, both of these organizations continue to work together to continue space exploration. There is enough space in both America and outer space for these two space organizations, and a lot of others to thrive. Both SpaceX and NASA should learn from each other and continue to revolutionize space travel and exploration. It can also be that NASA should hand over the Mars project to SpaceX and other private companies and focus on deep space exploration. So what do you think about these two companies and their programs in the future? How far will they revolutionize future space exploration by working together? Let us know your views and questions in the comment section below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel and press the bell notification to remain notified of our future exciting videos.